this GIMP workshop, we are going to color an Art Nouveau coloring page with the use of a color palette and the mouse. There is a download link for the coloring page and the example image in the video description. When we've opened our coloring page, we will first make some adjustments. Hold the Ctrl key and simultaneously roll the mouse wheel to zoom in to the face more or less like so. When we press and hold the spacebar, we can move our image by moving the mouse. We can see that there are a lot of gray pixels and also that they are fairly big, so we will work on that. Go to Image and hit Scale Image. Fill in 2000 at the width. Hit the Tab key so the height changes proportional. Then click on Scale. Right away we can see that there are much more pixels, which will make our lines much smoother. But there are still gray pixels. Zoom out a bit and move to the face again. Now we go to Image, Mode and hit Indexed. Here we choose the option Use Black and White and confirm by clicking on Convert. Then we go back to Image, Mode, and now we click on RGB so we can work on our image with color. And now we have a proper line drawing with only black and white pixels. Go to View, Zoom and Fit Image in Window. Click on the Duplicate button at the bottom of the Layers panel to make a duplicate of this layer. Then we click on Windows, Dockable Dialogs, and we hit Palettes. Here we can choose a predefined color palette. I've chosen four web colors. Double click on the thumbnail to open it. We can enlarge the palette window. Place the cursor on the edge, and when it changes into a double arrow, we can pull out the window. Then we click on the most right zoom icon to maximize the palette in the window. Activate the Select by Color tool. Zoom in a bit. Click in the black of the image so all the lines are selected. Now we choose a brown color in the palette and click on it. Go to the foreground background colors and drag this brown foreground color into the image so all of our lines become brown. We do this because the lines in Art Nouveau images are usually, if not always, brown. Press Ctrl+Shift+A to deselect. Activate the Bucket Fill tool. We will start by coloring the skin. Click on the color that you want to use for the skin and then click in the area that you want to fill with this color. When you do not like a certain color, you do not have to undo this. You can just pick another color and click in the same area again. Use the Ctrl key in combination with the mouse wheel to zoom in or out. And use the spacebar in combination with the mouse to move the whole image. Sometimes the lines do not connect and the neighboring area gets colored also, like here. In that case, we undo this with Ctrl+Z and first connect these lines. Click on the Layers tab. Make the bottom layer invisible. Then click on the Color Picker tool and on the brown of the lines. Now we activate the Pencil tool and we make the size about 6. Zoom in and just click to connect the lines like so. Make the top layer invisible and the bottom layer visible. Activate the bottom layer. Press the D key to make black our foreground color and connect the lines in this layer also. Make the top layer visible again and active. Press Shift+B to activate the Bucket Fill tool again. Then click on the Palette Editor tab. Press Ctrl+Shift+J to maximize the image. Now we can continue coloring by clicking a color in the palette and then clicking in an area. When you want to use the same color again, but are not sure which one it was, you can activate the color picker by pressing the O key and click in the already used color. Then press Shift+B again to activate the bucket fill tool and continue coloring with this color. When we fill in the areas, we have to be careful not to click on the lines like so. When this happens, we press Ctrl Z to undo this and try again. For the sake of the tutorial, we will now go fast forward. When all the areas are filled with color, we press Ctrl-Shift-J to fit the image in the window. Then activate the Select by Color tool and select the skin areas. Make the paintbrush active. Make the opacity about 20 and choose brush hardness 0.25. The size should be around 50. In the color palette, we choose a soft color, which is just a bit darker than the skin. Now we are going to shade and blend the face and the skin, like so. Pressing the left or right bracket key makes the brush smaller or bigger. Because we have selected a certain area, the surrounding areas are not affected. Use Ctrl Z to undo when you have gone too far. We can also choose a lighter color and play with the opacity and the size. Skin is to our liking, we press Shift O to activate the Select by Color tool again. Click on the dress to select it. Then press the P key to make the paintbrush active again. Choose a darker color to make shades in the dress. Here too, we can change the opacity to make the effect stronger or softer, or choose a different color. When we still want to do some more coloring on the skin, we cannot just select it with the Select by Color tool, because it now has shades, blends and different colors. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to first deselect the current selection. Click on the Layers tab. Select the bottom layer, which is our line drawing. Select the Fuzzy Select tool. Click on the second button at the mode, which is Add to Current Selection. Then click in the areas of the skin that you want to select. Activate the top layer again and click on the palette editor. Press the P key for the paintbrush and now we can continue with the skin. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect the current selection. In this way we can make shades and blends in our whole image. We will go a bit fast forward now. Thank you. press Shift O again to make the Select by Color tool active. Now click in the blue of the circle. Choose white as the fill color. Press the P key to make the paintbrush active. Make the opacity 100. And make sure that the brush is 0.25. We make the size about 900. And we click several times in the center of the circle, so this lights up a bit. We can do the same with the green areas, but then we use brush 0.75 and make it a bit bigger. We leave the background and the object where the woman is leaning against as they are. When we feel it's okay, we press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. Then we press Ctrl-Shift-J to fit the image in the window. Now press Shift-O to activate the Select by Color tool. Select the gray object at the bottom, like so. Press the P to activate the paintbrush. Make sure the opacity is 100%. Choose Brush Sand Dunes. Make its size about 1000. Choose in the color palette the color white. Then click several times in the image, more or less like so. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. Now we press the Shift plus O keys again to activate the Select by Color tool. Click in the background to select it. Press the P key for the paintbrush. Choose brush grass. Then choose a color that's just a bit darker than the background. Now click several times in the background to make a nice structure, like so. Press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. When all is to our liking, we can close the palette editor by clicking here and then hit Close tab. In the same way, we can close the palettes. Click on the Layers tab. Then reduce the Layers panel to its original size, so when we close and open GIMP again, it will open with these default settings. Press Ctrl-Shift-J for the last time. Activate the bottom layer. Press the U key to activate the Fuzzy Select tool. Click in the background to select it. Then we activate the top layer again. Right-click on the top layer and hit Add Layer Mask. Just click Add. Press the L key to activate the Blend tool. Zoom out a bit and draw a line to make a gradient in the background. We can draw this line again and again until it is to our liking. Then press Ctrl-Shift-A to deselect. Now go to Colors and Levels. Adjust the levels to your liking. And click OK. And there we have it, a beautiful Art Nouveau coloring page. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please give it a thumbs up, maybe leave a nice comment, and subscribe if you haven't done already to support my channel. I would appreciate it very much. Thank you for watching.